equipment, and two, it can damage you. The second safety rule is the five or more whistle blows. So if I blow my whistle, you immediately stop what you're doing. If you have an arrow on your bow, you don't let the bow go. You're gonna just slowly release it. You're gonna put up the arrow in your quiver, save up the bow, and walk back behind the waiting line. Make sure you never fire if I blow my whistle five or more times. Secondly, is if there's an arrow that falls in the range, I do not want you to pick up the arrow. I want you to leave it where it is, and I will come and supply you with another arrow. So, any questions for safety? We're good?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, cool. So, next is the whistle blows. There are four whistles that you should listen for. The first one is to get a bow. I will blow my whistle two times. You walk to get your bow, and then you find a spot on the shooting line. And there will be two people to one target. The next is shoot. I will blow my whistle one time. When I blow my whistle one time, you shoot towards the target. When you're done shooting, you come save up your bow, you walk, there's no running, and then you wait behind the waiting line. And then after everyone is done shooting, I will blow my whistle three times and we will retrieve the bows. And after we're done shooting, I will demonstrate how to retrieve a bow. I mean an arrow, sorry. Okay, so I need for the people that were here Friday, which I believe are a lot of you, Christina, can you help them with just going over how the draw length of the arms? And I'll go, who wasn't here? Leo, I believe, yeah. Jordy, and E. Y'all stay with me behind this waiting line, and we're going to go over find the dominant eye in your draw length. So, if everybody wants to get up. Did any of y'all bring y'all strings from Friday?
I got mine.
Good job.
Extra points.
It's okay if you didn't. It's for muscle memory. So y'all go in the back with Christina and just help them out. You were here. E, you want to come in the front? Oh, there you go. Jordy, you come too. Greg,
can
you
remember
here?
The 11 steps?
So y'all just go over, y'all draw in, and go over the 11 steps that y'all remember. Okay. So for y'all, I want y'all to get a straight line. Okay. I want y'all to put up your hands, make a circle in the middle, and I want you to try and find my nose in between that circle. Both eyes have to be open. So try and find my nose. Your right eye, right eye. Okay. Cool deal. So that was finding your dominant eye. This determines what side you draw the bow on. So you are all right eye. You're going to pick up the bow and draw on your right side. Okay? Next is the draw length. So I want you to... All y'all are going to have your left now, arm forward. And I want you to act like you're pulling the bow back and stop with your middle finger on your crease of your lip. Or lips. Like this.
Like you're hooking a fish in the mouth.
Okay. So yours is too short. I need for you to bring it back just a little bit more.
That's good.
Make sure this finger right here is curved like it's holding a bow. Okay. There you go. Good job. Perfect. Yours is a little short, so make sure you lengthen it out. There you go.
Yep.
Good job.
So this elbow and that hand is in line.
Okay.
Yeah. So the reason we do, well, I have a picture of what it's supposed to be. So this is the correct way to hold the bow and pull the string. You see what I'm trying to find?
Okay, so my elbow should
be your elbow
behind.
It shouldn't be too far, and it shouldn't be.
All right. It's just straight right behind
yes,
your ear.
Exactly.
There you go.
It's kind of awkward.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's
awkward because you're not used to drawing a bow.
You're going to have to know all those. Yeah. You've got to listen to them first.
All right, if everybody wants to come back to the waiting line, y'all stand in a straight line.
I don't know what you do, but what a real bow.
This is a real bow.
Then yes, we can get a
bow. Okay, does anybody want to volunteer to demonstrate the 11 steps?
wasn't here on Friday.
So now we're going to go over the 11 steps of archery. They're, you use them to shoot the bow every time, just memory. So Christina's going to help. So first is stance. Okay, our feet are going to be shoulder width apart. Her front foot is going to be a half a step back, and there's going to be a slight turn, kind of like in between the target and here, pointing kind of towards 2 o'clock. Next is knocking an arrow. Yep, knock might not sound very familiar. It's an archery term, but there's going to be on the arrow, see, it has like a, to put a string in the middle, you're going to hear a click sound. And that means that you're knocking the arrow. When you knock, I mean, when you pick up the arrow, you're gonna want your finger to, thumb to be pointing down, and you're gonna wanna pick up the arrow up and over the bow and knock it onto the string. There's gonna be a knot on the string that you knock the arrow under. Next is the draw hand fingers. So there's gonna be what's called an archer's groove. Your three fingers, your first index finger, the middle finger, and the finger following, that's your archer's groove, the first joints. So, next is the bow hand set. So she's gonna set your, you're not drawing yet. So it's just draw hand set and bow hand set. Then you're gonna pre-draw, pick up the bow, parallel to the ground. Then it's gonna be draw, you're drawing the arrow back. Anchor your finger onto your lip, which is the next step. Then you're gonna aim, aiming towards the target. Then you're going to shot setup, which is the muscles in the back. I should be able to put a tennis ball in the back, and where her shoulder blades, her muscles are gonna be holding that tennis ball, so to say. Next is release. She's gonna be painting the face. She's gonna relax the hand. Paint the face, touch the shoulder, which is release, follow through, and then reflect on the shot. So she's reflecting on everything she just did, reflecting on where the arrow went. So I'll go over them again if y'all want to do them with me. So first is stance. You're going to want to straddle the shooting line. For right now, y'all can straddle the waiting line. So feet shoulder width apart. My front foot is going to have a slight turn to it and a half a step back. I'm going to knock my arrow, pick it up with the thumb down, up and over, knocking it. We have draw hand set, the archer's groove, the bow hand set, pre-draw, I'm going to draw, anchor my finger on my lips. Yeah. That's good, I got you. So it's anchor. Then I'm going to aim towards the target. I'm going to shot set up, make sure those muscles are ready. I'm going to release, relax the hand, follow through, paint the face and touch the shoulder, and then reflect. Does anybody have questions?
I would say the people that didn't come to the workshop need to go second.
Yeah,
probably.
I'll make sure of that. That's Jordy, E, and Leo. So I need everyone behind the waiting line. Thank you. Okay. So if y'all remember, there are two people to one target. So when I blow my whistle two times, you're going to walk to get your bow and find a spot on the line. Do you remember what to do with the quiver?
Yeah.
Just moving it in front of you? Okay. So.
No, hey, don't go. So you're going to get a right-handed bow.
The ones to the left are the left-handed bows, if y'all remember. Remember, bows on toes, I didn't tell y'all, I forgot to. Whenever you're waiting to shoot, you're gonna put your bow on your front toe, your left toe.
Yeah, Mike.
Or your front
dominant.
Mike, you right hand?
He's left hand.
He's left.
Well, right hand. Yeah.
Dominant. You wanna go wait on the house fire with the bows?
gonna help you shoot the first time. After that, you will do it. So try to listen to what she's telling them. It helps you reinforce. Yeah, yeah. It's because they've already shot before. It's right. It's just these that'll take a little longer. Do not close your eyes. Keep both eyes open. You lose your depth perception when you close your eyes. So it affects your target. You were here, weren't you?
Friday?
Yeah.
All right, now remember y'all let me set this.
You remember how to pick up the arrow? We never dry fire.
I wouldn't even dry fire.
Don't even pull it back without the arrow.
I'm ready to let it fucking rip.
Look at Michael's stance. Look at his stance. Work on your technique, because remember, you'll be up in front of classes just demonstrating. If you demonstrate wrong, they copy you wrong as a teacher.
Bullseye.
Means you move your arm.
Huh?
You move your arm. Folks, don't forget to turn your elbow so you don't hyperextend your elbow, girls. You get it. Okay, pull your elbow back, Nick. Nick, you're not pulling your arm's not coming back all the way.
Bring this elbow back right here.
That's good.
Bring it some more.
You hit yourself. Yes.
Oh, ow.
I'm missing it.
Yeah, he's going to break.
Yes.
I'm missing one.
Christina, you look awesome.
Do I look awesome?
I was watching her. I wasn't watching you.
Oh, that was what you want?
Feet shoulder width apart, Michael.
I just remember when you follow through, paint the face and touch the face.
So a battle is what you want, eh?
Bring the elbow back a little bit.
There you go. What?
Yes. On commercial bows, they set your draw length. Mm-hmm. But because everybody has to use the same bow in this competition, you have to use those string bows to memorize the draw. He gave everybody a string bow that came to the workshop. Means you forgot to turn that elbow out the first time.
That's a move.
Oh, that's a painful lesson. You got to remember to rotate that arm.
Yeah.
When you show E how you turn an arm out. No, put your hand on the wall. Put your hand on the wall, and then you turn it. You so after you've got it drawn, she turns her elbow.
Wait, what?
Let me see what you're doing.
No, I turn my arm out, but whenever I release, I turn
it. Okay, back behind the lock. Back behind the lock.
Thank you.
Yes, I did. Alright, so everybody's done shooting.
Next group.
Jordan, no. We We're going to go retrieve the arrows first. So I'm going to go teach y'all how to retrieve. But y'all need to listen to... Are y'all listening, Nick Amy? Cool. We're going to go to that first target over there, and we're going to demonstrate how to retrieve an arrow. Y'all can come.
Down to the blue line, folks.
Everybody can see me? Yeah, I know. Your first shot, you
Yep.
If it's touching the line, it's in. Alright, so retrieving a bow. You're going to put your left foot on the target, your left hand, or which if you're doing it from the other side, it's the other hand. You're going to place your hand right above it, pull it out. You're going to want to make sure you're looking behind you to make sure there's no one behind you and not hitting someone. So I'm looking behind me, and I'm placing the bow on the ground. I mean the arrow on the ground. So, foot looking behind, and placing down. When I'm done taking out all my five arrows that I shot, I pick up the arrows, hit them on the top. I'm going to place my hands on the tip and right below the fletchings, and I'm going to carry them just like this. I don't want to carry them like this because there is a chance that it could fall, hit you in the chest, or so this is just better for safety. Everything is safety in archery. So everyone get to their targets, and I need one person behind the blue line waiting for their partner to get their arrows, and then once they're done, you go get your arrows.
Oh, it counts. It touches the line. If it's on the line, you count the higher number. Oh, it was yours. He's claiming it. Y'all do sound like high school kids. Put your knee up against it too, Nick. That's why it's turning on you. Use the whole side of your leg. Michael, put your foot up against the target. Yes, there we go.
I took the higher five.
This is very good technique from Christina.
Make sure you look behind you.
Okay. Perfect technique from Deidre.
Yeah, I'm not leaving you. I don't want to be
okay. She's carrying it properly. And you're looking for things that she might not have said today to reinforce tomorrow. Because it's hard for them to get it all, you know. Okay. Here will be the true test for the three newbies, right?
Yes. Alright, so everyone's behind the waiting line. E, Jordy, and Leo. Let's see, I'll turn this off.
We have arrows stuck in the... Maybe just make them go to where there's none.
Hey, y'all can go to the ones with the arrows in them. Okay. Y'all
Now, why would you not really want to do that?
Do what?
If they've never shot before and they're real kids, why do you never leave the arrows?
Because I need to critique them.
Yes, you did.
All right. Y'all come to the empty ones first, then. Sorry, guys. And remember, bows on toes. Y'all want to straddle the shooting line for me, please? There you go. So y'all with me on this target.
Below the little...
Below the knot.
Yeah.
You're going to do your hand set?
Say the button.
It's the button. Oh, yeah. So draw hand set. Those fingers are going to be below.
Yeah. Three fingers below.
Is it supposed to be all the way on this shirt? Like I have to force it on?
Yeah, you'll hear a little clicking noise.
Oh, there you go.
There you go. So draw hand set.
Okay, look where his where he's got it knocked though.
This should be a fire.
No.
Yeah. That's
you,
the dry fire.
You
roll.
Never ever pull the string back and draw fire unless you want to really tear up the bow. Right? As in it will screw up the bow. You never ever ever do that.
Hey, bow's on toesy.
Love it.
It's okay.
Just watch what she's doing right now.
Yes.
You've got 3 minutes. Right? Something.
Now pre-draw. Draw.
And she did.
Anchoring that finger.
Real well. Right. What can I find?
Shot set.
Too much information.
Release. Okay. That's a good job. Just,
Oh, I thought I was going to do this. I thought you were going to
do that. Students do not listen.
Are you going to get this one? Just remember all of the first.
But these are built to handle that. But.
Yeah. It,
no, it's not. Right,
oh.
Yeah. 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 Ignorance is not always bliss. Good job, Jordy. Okay. You all go. Go in there and get the other group to come in here because we're a little behind. I'm going to swap out.
Draw that. Mm-hmm. Anchoring that finger on the lip.
Hook your mouth.
Hook your mouth.
There you go. All right. Now you're going to aim it. Shot set up. Relax the hand and release. There you go.
That was scary.
He did
well, he moved his arm.
Falling back. Just remember to paint the face and reflect.
Okay. Leo. You can keep shooting.
Y'all can keep shooting. There you go.
You might want to gather up your arrows that are in the... Okay, come hang up your bow. Come hang up. Y'all, come hang up your bow. Okay. Leo, come hang up your bow. And go retrieve. Tell them, I mean, she, you need to get them to go retrieve.
Behind the waiting line. Y'all want to go behind the new people behind the waiting line? Hey, E, you got to retrieve the arrows. So.
Okay. Remember how to do it?
That guy just let you borrow this stuff?
Yes, if you get certified, the Wildlife and Fisheries will loan you the equipment. You done come back and get it from you. That's why we want to get certified. So they'll loan us the equipment. In all the states that do the in-school archery program, that is true. So Texas, Kentucky, all of these are doing that. So you have to prove that you can safely use the equipment. Right? We'll be taking your written test today or Wednesday, right?
Wednesday.
Okay, we're 3 minutes behind. So who did not come to the workshop last time? Okay, so we've got three people. What did she just say?
Don't dry fire a bow.
Yes, what's a dry fire of a bow?
Shooting
over an arrow.
Marcella, what's a dry fire of a bow? That's it. Okay.
Somebody did it in the last class, so we just want to make sure everybody understands. Next is the five or more whistle blow. So if I blow my whistle five or more times, it's going to sound like this. We're going to stop what we're doing. We're not going to shoot the arrow. If you have an arrow, we're going to release it. We're going to come walk and put up our bows. And if we have an arrow, put up the arrow and come back behind the waiting line. Another thing is if there's an arrow that's dropped on range, we want to make sure that we don't bend down to get it. I will supply you with another arrow. So just make sure to never walk on range when you're shooting.
Thank you.
That's it for safety rules, so you have to understand all of the safety rules. Awesome. Matt, yep. You're going to be my helper. For the people that were here for Friday, I want you to go in the back, I guess behind that black line, and just practice your draw lengths, practice all the 11 steps. Make sure you remember. And I want you to do
okay, y'all are going to learn the basics.
Okay, so first things first.
You have to list them on the test.
All three of y'all to put your hands up like this, make a circle in the middle. And I need for you to look at my nose. Find your nose with both eyes open. Both eyes. So your left eye. Left. Did you find my nose? Okay, left, right, and right. So what I just did was find y'all dominant eye. So yours was left. You're going to be drawing the bow on your left side. It might be weird at first if you're right handed, but the reason we do this is because your left eye is going to be the dominant eye aiming at that target. So we want to draw on our left side. And y'all are going to be right side, so you're going to be drawing with your right hand left and forward. Okay, so now we're going to go over the draw line of your arm. So y'all can just get a stance. Facing towards the wall. I need for y'all to pick up this arm. Pick up this arm, and you're gonna draw back and anchor your finger on your lip. Okay? So you're gonna have, it's called an archer's groove. So these fingers are gonna be holding the string. And whenever you're pulling back, this finger's gonna stick out kind of like this, and you're gonna touch your lip.
Hook the fish.
Yeah.
In the mouth. There we go.
Yeah. So, try it for me. Okay, so I need for you to pull back just a little bit more.
Release how to release.
See how my arm is.
Face to face.
Face to face.
What?
So, this is going to be the correct draw length right here. So this is what I'm looking for. It's like you're having a string in your hand. So, drawing back. There you go. That's perfect. Hunter, you want to try it on? This is the correct one. So you're going to fingers in hand.
So you need to show them left bows there.
Oh, okay. For you, since you're left-handed,
I got tape on the end. Step back, and you want it to be slightly turned, 2 o'clock. Next is knocking an arrow. Yes, we want this thumb facing down, and whenever we grab an arrow, we want to make sure that we grab below these fletchings. So it'll look like this when you grab an arrow. So make sure thumb's down, you're grabbing it, you're knocking the arrow on the bow. So that's knock. Next is the draw hand set. So this is called your archer's groove, if y'all remember from Friday. It's the index finger, middle finger, and the finger following. And it's those first joints that you want on the string. So draw hand set, bow hand set. You want to make sure you're left-handed?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's why it's awkward. Okay, you want to make sure that hand's relaxed. It's not gripping it too tight. You want to draw the bow. I'm sorry, it's pre-draw first. Then draw the bow. Then you anchor that finger on the lip, kind of like a fish hook. Then you're going to aim downrange at the target. Shot setup, which is these muscles in the back. You want to make sure that they're tight and ready to shoot. This is just to make sure that your body's not relaxing, you're ready to shoot. Then you're going to release. Relax the hand. You're not going to push the string or pull on it, you're just going to let go, relax. Then it's follow through and reflect. So, if y'all want to go over them with me all together, we'll straddle this waiting line right here. Pretend like that's the shooting line. So, Alonzo, you want to make sure that, yeah, you can go back one. You want to make sure you're short width apart, Alonzo. Okay. So we have stance. Then we have knocking the bow, making sure the thumb is down, picking up the arrow, knocking it. You're going to knock. A lot of people had trouble with this, so I'm going to walk around and show you all. You're going to, there's a knot right here that you're going to knock on. Do you see?
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to make sure that the arrow is sitting on this. Got it? Who wasn't here? Okay. This is the little knot right here.
Under or underneath?
Under.
Everybody else got it? Yeah, you're going to do it underneath.
This hand rest in that one.
Yeah, and rest in this. Okay.
And maybe the beginners don't put them all in one group. So,
okay.
Because if we, some of the rest don't get to shoot all of it, it's okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, stance, knot, draw hand set. Bow hand set, you're going to pre-draw, draw, anchor that finger, we're going to shot, we're going to aim, shot set up, release, follow through, and reflect. Awesome. Everybody got that? Okay. Toes behind the waiting line. I don't think I went over the whistle blows with y'all, or did I?
Yeah, five.
Okay.
Just a 5 minute.
To get the bow, you're going to hear two whistle blows. So I'm going to... That means to get your bow. Next is the shooting whistle, which is only one whistle blow. So you're going to shoot. After you're done shooting, you walk back to put up your bow, and then you wait behind the waiting line for everyone else to finish. And then the third one is retrieving the arrows, so I'm going to three whistle blows. And I'll teach y'all how to retrieve after the first group shoots. So
if you drop your arrow.
Oh, she said that.
Oh, she did?
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so first group. Matt, you don't feel well, correct?
Yeah, I think you should have 10.
Okay. Okay, cool. So everyone can go at the same time, actually.
Great.
And if I can get the first three people, not yet, you gotta wait for my whistle blow. The people that didn't come to the workshop, if y'all can just go over there, I'll go over it with y'all first. So, behind the waiting line, thank you. No, y'all can all come. There's enough people to shoot at all the targets.
The lefties need to stand on the other side.
So. Oh, yeah. Y'all can be by each other. Doesn't matter. You, all you're going to do is shoot at the table. The three people are going to move. You need to come to the other side. So all you're going to do is move this way. So y'all are going to be on this first record right here, and Cara will be on this.
Straddle, bows on toes.
Get on the shooting line, remember bows on toes. So we're not playing with our bow, it's resting on our toe. Is that wrong?
On the front foot.
Yes. So you want to come to the way you want. I'm going to give them their bows first, their arrows first, and then I'll come to y'all, and y'all can all shoot at this.
Yeah. Matt, why don't you put out the arrows of the people that have gone through the course?
Yeah.
It's just the people that have never done it. We don't want them going unsupervised the first time. Way y'all don't have to rush shooting.
Right,
tomorrow, Wednesday, everybody will have known this, so we will be able to get a lot more shooting done. You can see why we don't certify people that just come to the class, because they don't know all the safety and teaching.
So now you're going to draw handset, bow handset. You're going to pre-draw. Draw.
That one's a little harder.
Anchor that hand. You're going to aim. Shot set up. Release. And follow through.
Very good.
That was very good. All right. So you can still shoot.
So you get
five arrows. And whenever you're done, just go away behind it.
What's the
Then you add up your score.
Then you're going to draw it back. The target, not the screen. It's okay. You just got to be confident. Just make sure this arm is straight right here, okay? You're going to draw it back.
All the way back?
All the way back. It's okay. You're okay? You got it. That's perfect.
Okay.
That's good. So you're going to anchor it. You're going to aim. Shot set up. You're going to aim.
I don't know if I'm aiming.
You're going to use both eyes open, okay? You're going to look at the target. Maybe put your elbow back a little bit more. There you go. That's perfect. Really? That's perfect.
Oh, you made 45? Anybody beat 45 points? Count up your score when you get done. Matt has 45. Anybody beat him?
Up and over.
Are we supposed to be counting?
Matt is saying.
Is that the time?
No, you've got a few more minutes.